Hey everybody, John Van Dyke here in New Jersey Exposed. Today is Tuesday, March 22nd, 2022. Time is 6:44 p.m. Yes, Jersey time. All right, we got another update to a story I just did about a sexual predator, more specifically a Dalton police officer. And this came out right, I found this right after I did the video, but we'll add it on to just more pieces to the puzzle about this hero here. You know, the well-trained professionals, they're always out there protecting us, but we know better. We know they're not protecting anybody but the government and their pension. This is reported on dailycitizen.news. This is dated March 18, 2022. Reads as follows. Lawsuit claims Dalton police officer commanded intern to perform sex acts against her will. And here it is. All right, let's find out. A civil rights lawsuit filed in federal court in Rome claims a Dalton Police Department officer, while on duty, performed a sex act on a department intern against her will and commanded her to perform a sex act on him. Now, I always question things like this. You know, why didn't the intern say something or try to set things up to get this guy in trouble? The lawsuit by Jane Doe names former officer Ethan Wayne Pugh, P-U-G-H, or Pugh, and the city of Dalton as defendants. So once again, the taxpayers are going to pay the price for this bad cop, because the bad cop was in uniform, did it on the job. Meanwhile, in a criminal case against Pugh, the 30-year-old Resaca resident was charged Tuesday with violation of oath by a public officer, sexual battery, aggravated sexual battery, and public indecency. He was booked into the Whitfield County Jail Tuesday and released on $20,000 bond the same day. In a statement, the Dalton Police Department said on July 10, 2020, the Dalton Police Department was notified of criminal accusations against the officer. That information was promptly turned over to the Georgia Bureau of Investigation. On the same day, the officer offered his resignation to the department, and it was accepted. They should have fired his ass. Why are they giving him a resignation? The Dalton Police Department takes any allegation of misconduct seriously and makes sure they are thoroughly investigated by the proper authority. Any question regarding these incidents should be directed to the Georgia Bureau of Investigation. You know what I think? You know, he resigned, but that should be changed to fired. Because once these allegations are substantiated and he's guilty, he should be fired and he should not have a resignation on his thing. City officials refer question guardians, blah, 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 blah. Okay, according to the Doe's complaint, in the summer of 2019, when she was 21, she became an intern at Dalton Police Department with the goal of becoming a fourth generation of her family and the first woman in her family to serve in law enforcement. She was an intern from June 3rd, 2019 to July 11th, 2019. So my question here again, if she's a family of law enforcement, why couldn't she go to somebody in that family and say, look, this is what this officer has committed atrocities against me. What should I do? Part of her duties was attending a weekly ride-along with a patrol officer, spending the day observing that officer on duty. On July 8th, she was assigned to ride along with Pugh. The complaint said that while the two were walking towards Pugh's patrol car, Pugh purposely, intentionally grabbed Miss Doe's buttocks and did so without warning or consent. The complaint said later, Pugh drove them to a secluded and empty lot where he parked the car in which he and Miss Doe were the only occupants, both seated in the front, and locked the doors of the patrol car. Without warning or the consent, Defendant Pugh leaned over and began forcibly kissing Miss Doe on the mouth and with his tongue. The complaint said Doe pulled away from Pugh until she was against the passenger door and did not kiss him back. The complaint said that Pugh placed his hand inside her pants and committed an act that was unwanted, uninvited, and unwarranted. During the afternoon, as the ride-along continued, the complaint said Pugh again drove them to a secluded spot. So my question is, why is she continuing this? The complaint said, then commanded Miss Doe in a frightening tone of voice to perform sex act on him. Okay. Now, I'm going to interject here. And ladies, take this as advice. If you got a situation where a man forcefully intimidates you to perform a sexual act on him, I'm assuming it's oral sex. In a case like that, you go down and as he's enjoying it, you bite the mother effer off. Or you bite it so hard that he's going to have to go to the hospital. Okay? And then he's going to have to explain why his penis is half bitten off. That's the way you handle that. The complaint said Doe feared for her safety because they were alone and Pug was armed and much larger than her. The complaint says she complied with his command, fearing that defendant Pug would rape her if she did not. Well, again, he's going to rape her. There's going to be some DNA, right? You know, you have to think of situation. All right, this is like, you know, not a life and death, but could be a life and death situation with these predators with badges that, okay, this is an extreme situation. It's going to call for extreme actions. And the way to do that, you know, biting it as hard as you can. And, you know, if you can, punch his nuts or something. But you're going to leave evidence on him that he can't. Because he's going to have to explain. You're going to go back and say, look, this is what he did. And I bit the shit out of him. And he's at the hospital now getting his dick sewed back on. You know what? You got evidence now. Because right now, she don't really have any evidence unless she's got some DNA on her shirt or something. Or spit the evidence out into a napkin and kept it. The complaint said Pook drove them back to police headquarters where he threatened Miss Doe, directing her not to tell anyone what happened because he would get fired. His wife would come after Miss Doe, and no one would believe her if she did report him. You see? This is some of the things that these cops play on, that nobody will believe me. Now, how many times have we heard about these badge bunnies who get married to cops and they claim they're afraid to call police because they don't think anybody will believe them? The complaint said that Doe later befriended the director of a local center for those who have been sexually abused. She eventually confided her experience with Pug with that woman. With that woman's support, Doe reported Pug to the police department on July 10, 2020. He resigned that same day and the department turned the investigation over to GBI. Well, we know why he resigned. That gets him out of the investigation. And, you know, he's not going to get fired from the job. And so if he resigns, he's not fired. And if he can beat the charges, I guess he could go back and be a cop again. The Whitfield County Grand Jury indictment of Pug said that on July 8, 2019, Pug, while on duty as a police officer, did engage in sexual contact with a college student doing an internship with the police department and assigned to do a ride-along with Pug. The description of Pug's actions in the indictment matches a number of claims in the complaint. There must be some evidence, you know, maybe there's something known about his private parts that he can't hide. Pug admitted to violating the department's policy on harassment and discrimination in the workplace and signed a waiver of pre-disciplinary hearing in which he admitted, I did not treat a group of females with respect and was not courteous to them. My behavior asking for unwelcome requests and comments may have led this group of females to feel intimidated and uncomfortable in the workplace. All right, so it's more than one of this is implying. The complaint said the conduct for which Pug was disciplined includes sending and or making inappropriate... Oh! Text messages! So he needs another charge. Stupidness. So now you're sending text messages out and now you've got evidence. You got written evidence. Request for photographs of female officers and female judges. Oh, and a female... Wow, even a judge? The complaint said that a captain recommended that Pug be fired at that time. Instead, Pug was suspended without pay and given a written reprimand, a performance contract, and remedial training. You know, the person that allowed that to go should be fired. This is the blue line of bullshit protecting him. Doe is being represented by Atlanta attorneys Andrew Beal and Melinda Brown of Buckley Beal and Jonathan Grunberg of WGW Law and Ringo attorney McCracken Poston. The city had enough knowledge about the officer Pug's conduct before the ride along and with that client to know that she never should have been in the car. So he had a history prior to this. This poor woman didn't know what was going on. Gets in the car with his predator, this sexual predator, and bootlickers, I love to hear from you. And you so-called good cops out there, I'd love to hear from you too. But I'm not going to hold my breath because I know you're not going to say anything. Back to blue, no matter what they do, right? just an isolated incident, along with, you know, the blue line bullshit and you propagandists and you bootleggers, you've changed the meaning of isolated incidents. Isolated now means a lot. It doesn't mean nothing, a little, a minimum. But as you can imagine, this lawsuit does not bring up and force her to relive that awful... does nothing but bring up and force her to relive that awful time, Beale said. We hope the police department uses this opportunity to discuss the resolution of the case, if no other reason than to minimize the impact of her going through the litigation process. She's prepared to do that, she's committing to do that, and she's capable of doing that. But we hope that's not entirely necessary. Asked about the criminal charges against Pug, Beale said that Doe is glad that she had an impact, that he is not going to be around to do this next person. But he said the experience has definitely had an impact on Doe's plan to pursue a career in law enforcement. Well, she got a bad case of what many of them are all about. Not saying all of them, but they're out there, and who wants to take that chance, right? District Attorney Burt Poston said he had conflicted out of the case, meaning that because it was a Dalton police officer, he removed himself from the case to avoid any potential conflict of interest. Lookout Mountain District Attorney Chris Arndt is handling the case. Pug joined the Dalton Police Department in December 2015, so he's got, what, six years? After graduating from the Georgia Regional Police Academy in Rome, according to the post on the department's website, he's a 2009 graduate of Castle View High School in Castle Rock, Colorado, and attended classes at Colorado Technical University. He's also an Army... Oh, he's an Army veteran! There you go! Serving from June 2009 till November 2013. Well, how many times have I talked about that, right? So here's what's going to happen is, I don't know, unless they've got some preponderance of evidence, but I don't know if they have concrete evidence to prove her case in a criminal court, because criminal is beyond a reasonable doubt. Now, in civil court, she's going to win. They're going to settle this lawsuit because there is a preponderance of evidence. As long as you have 51%, you win. So I think rather than the town going to court and all that, they're going to offer a nice settlement and not accept any responsibility in the settlement. Hopefully, I would hope that she goes through with the whole thing and causes this officer to have to get on the stand and maybe talk. And because it looks like she's got a pretty good case, text messages, it appears there's other females involved in this, so they will come and testify. And it's not going to look good for Ethan Wayne Pug. And then Pug's got another problem besides criminal and civil court. He's got to have a divorce court problem too, because you're married, you're a badge bunny, married to this predator, and I hope he doesn't have any kids, but are you going to go home to this guy? Knowing that you're living with a predator who could turn against you and cause you harm. Very sad. And also, the higher-ups, the brass that signed off on this guy and allowed him to stay on the force, he should have been fired. Once again, they're not held to the highest standard, the same standard as you and I. If this kind of crap went on, took place at your job, you think you'd be on the job? No, the boss would call you off and say, did you do this, you do that? And you'd be like, hammina, 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 and the person shows the boss text message stuff, you'd be out the freaking door. You wouldn't be there. At least not in any job I have. But you know how it is with the blue line of bullshit. They'll give them every opportunity to protect them. Very sad, very scary. This is what's running around out there in a police car, supposedly protecting us, which we all know is bullshit. They don't protect anything. They enforce laws and they protect the government. I'll put that link in the description. Go read the story yourself. Very interesting, very scary. Update to the story I just did. I'm John Van Dyke for New Jersey Exposed. Till next time.